thru on the left channel there, blokes. Oh, just because you guys are going the other one, really. I just take the free one. See if this is the right way. Sorry? That's a extra battery for the GoPro. Yeah. Should get all coverage, all the race this year. No! got enough water today. Yeah. a good run through the trees so far, mate. Yeah? Yeah, no, that's always the case, eh? Well, yeah, that's cool, man. I'll lead you through if you like. I mean, it's not... There's not that many ways around, but, try, yeah. I'll try yell if there's anything bad coming up. No worries. Good recovery, mate. Well done. Yeah. Sorry, mate. You'll make it. Whoa. I thought it was a bit easier than that. Take a run at it. Looks jumpable. Alright. pad. Second wind. Man, I came into the TiTrees. You know those skis that you were with? I went left and they all went right. And 100 meters later, they were all gone. Every single one of them, like not a single soul. And I'm thinking at least one of them should have done it right. Disappear. They just float down the river without paddling, eh? I guess there's two types of novices. Yeah. Well, it's a rudder, it's a brace backstroke for them, and that's how they control it, you know. They'll be stopped dead in the water and think that that's fine, but truth be told, you sort of have to move somewhere. Oh yeah. What do you reckon? I think I've gone left there before, and I think it's not the way. Devil. Poor boat. Yeah, have you seen that before? Ah, okay. Yeah, our buddies all practiced that and they went under the tree. And then the water rose and they went over the tree. And they were thinking, oh, what are we going to do, over or under? And you can't really do either, you have to go through. Did you see on the right side, you could actually go under one of the parts there? I got through without stopping paddling, eh? Yeah, straight through. Even easier than last time around on the right. It does, eh? Well, if we pop out into a big pool, I think that's the pool above Leatherheads, and then it's just the rapid and the finish. Whoop, that's another tree. I think this is the pool above Leatherheads. I hope. Yeah. Oh dear. got water there. I don't know, I'll find out if I'm about to get beached here or not. I think I'm gonna get beached here, I'll come over. Yeah, far right, yeah. Lucky. Yep, good one. Yeah, that's it. This could still be the Leatherhead's pool. I'm still holding out hope. That's the sweeper chopper. Not for us though. Symphony. wasn't the pool above Leatherheads. That wasn't the pool. Still a while yet. I think we're halfway. Nah. Well, we've been in the tea trees for 38 mins. You're right. Both of these are fine, just watch the log on the other side now. Yeah, come around, yeah. Left, I reckon. See if there's a channel on the left. No, there's not. Okay. No. Just sneak past slowly. Good one. Wonder what it tastes like. Worth it. Hooray, another jam. All right, we should be able to get around this one without too much bother. does, eh? Oh, every big pool to me looks like the Leatherhead's pool. Man, I'm the king of telling people that it's only just around the corner, 1k, you know, and then, still, not too long now. I thought about taking my spray deck off before I shoot Leatherheads, getting filled with water, and then pretending that I've paddled with that much water the whole way. At least I get some sympathy there. I know, I think he is the sweeper, but he's like counting the people in the river so that at 4 o'clock he can go and pick him up. That's what my dad said, and I believe it's 4 o'clock back there at Jimpity. So like, this is the stupid thing with the Avon, right? They have a cutoff up the river somewhere, and if you make that, then you can take as long as you like to get home. So correct, and you're the tiredest, and it's the darkest, and all the rest. So, mate, I finished a TiTrees run at 6:30 once, accidentally, in the moonlight. Great fun, 5-on-5 in the double plastic. Yeah, but it was so low because we basically just predicted it'd be higher, and it was too slow, so it wasn't like dangerous. Well, it wasn't, you know. Bit. Yeah. Well, dudes lead posses. Like, we're buddies with a bunch of other waypopper paddlers, and they're all Ascot Kayak Club guys years and years. And they're up at posses collecting their boats from, I think, TiTrees run, and they saw people heading off for a valley run at like 1 p.m. and it was like 0.4, and they're going, hey guys, do you know how where are you going? You know, do you know how far it is? And like, do you have a backup plan? Because you're gonna need it. No, now I paddled into Bill's once by myself at about 5:30. Like deliberately, I knew it was gonna be that late because I paddle upstream and then back down again if I've only got one car. And the cops were waiting there, and they were sort of like looking at me as if I'd done something wrong. And so I got out and went, hey, what's up? And they were looking for four kayakers who had set off at 9 o'clock in the morning, so you know, 12 hours or bloody a long time ago, and they hadn't finished the valley yet. And they ended up, what had happened was, three of them were walking, one of them had paddled down to Bell's and then driven away, and hadn't told anyone, and all of the wives had no idea who each other was. So there were four calls to the cops, four separate stories. They didn't know the colour of each other's boats. They didn't even know who the other wives were. So like, they were like, hey, we've been told to wait at Bell's. We've been waiting here all day and no one's arrived. And then like, they're not even at Bell's, they're at somewhere else, you know? So the guys were walking out and we ended up waiting there till about 7 o'clock, and they'd been walking for, you know, 4 hours. But you gotta think, I mean, if, you know, I don't know if you hike much, well, oh yeah, triathlons. So I mean, you know, 30 Ks of walking, there's no way that can take you more than like, well, I guess that could be 6 hours, yeah. So I mean, like, these guys were walking hell of a slow, and the cops went up there and they didn't have any torches, so luckily I had my torch with me. So we went and got their boats from, I can't remember, where were they? Oh, the one guy's boat at Bell's there, yeah. And then, funnily enough, last Tuesday, I was test filming my live coverage at Bell's, and I saw the rescue chopper come overhead. The RAC chopper circled a bit, and then it landed in the top car park at Bell's there. Yeah, I got video footage of it. I know. And the paramedics were all parked there, and they all had a conversation with the dudes, and then they flew off again. And then I found out later that a hiker had been injured. Right. Oh no, you're right. There's a little space there, just take it easy. It's not the nicest, but it is a way. Yeah, that'll do. Yeah, so I found out later that a hiker had been injured. He'd called up the emergency dudes and told them that he was at Bell's. And so I looked on Perth Now news report the day later, and they said someone slipped into Bell's and were washed away. Yeah, and it's bollocks. No one was near Bell's. I was at Bell's all day filming, And the helicopter came overhead and then, you know, buggered off north where the guy was. Nothing to do. He parked at Bell's and walked, see. They got confused. It'd be pretty funny if someone flew into Bell's just before the race. Ironic. It's like spectator falls into the rapids. Alright, this has to be the last little section. That round earth house is the marker, yeah. And the gauge is coming up pretty soon as well. And I am almost sunk. Well done. You turned getting a drink into a crazy zigzag. Remember when that used to happen in the hopper all the time, just without trying? Did you used to zigzag across the river? Uh-oh. Yeah. Oh, mate, I used to watch people, because I got the wave hopper a year before I started training all these other people in it, and all these newbies. And man, watching them, like, they would be in a river like this, hitting each bank, you know. It's gone bam, 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 you know, left, right, left, right. Just sad. And they'd be adamant that it's not them, you know. And then, like, 6 months or 3 months later, suddenly the boat just doesn't do it anymore, and you're like, what's going on? I like it now. Yeah, someone's taken off the dodgy rudder, or put a rudder on a keel or something. I'd follow the 515 if at all possible, because they're going to take really easy routes. Until they stuff up and then you pass them. Yeah. I followed a 5-1 down last year and they actually stayed in front of me the whole TiTrees. And if I had sort of powered on, I would have just been able to hang with them the whole way and not been stuffed once. Perfect run, but I slowed down actually. Gauge, nice one. Yeah, 0.7. 0.6, wow. Yeah, that's actually reading high as well, because it's been moved recently in the last few years, so. You got stuck on the little trick tree. The little gauge tree. just distraction tree, you call it. Yeah. Must be, gotta be. Well, you forget all the other pools in the tea trees. You think the tea trees are all tea trees. Oh, at least there's water in this pool. Bit shallow on the right there, just saw some waves breaking from the dudes in front. Yeah, I don't know where the good bit is though. I think it's just shallow all across. What do you reckon about the right side? Looks good? Yeah. Give it a bash. End of the day, we'll cut the corner at least inside. Oh dear, no water there. Yeah, nah. Ba-bum. Maybe just stick in the middle, I guess. Watch those guys. pee, just pee in it. Nope. Oh, I just got a boardy slope basically. So I got way too hot when I wore a wetsuit. I'd only wear it when I was assuming I'd fall out. And I've never fallen out in a race. I used to wear it in 2 meter water. But even then, like, it makes you so much bigger, like, because it's so thick, I actually struggle to fit into the boat. Like, or at least, you know, I'm a bit bigger, so everything needs to be adjusted and changed and sort of, you know, it's a bit different. So, if at all possible, I try not to. It's not like you ever get cold. Got a second one if you want. Yeah. Just try and do something about the dude blocking it at the bottom. Maybe choose alternative. You're right, go left of him. Can you go left of him? Left of that big rock that's out of the water. Oh, yeah, sweet. I know there's multiple channels here. You're right. You're right. Yeah, it's alright, mate. I'll show you where you should have gone. Should have gone here. There's the way. So you just do two 360s. Yeah, one rock and it's all over. Yeehaw! Oh no, you lost the water bottle.
Oh, no.
There it is. Go. Woo! I'll try to keep it on till the end. Now, a buddy of mine does that. Actually, it's a family friend. His son, you know, has played for years. And then also a girl at Main Peak, she does it. It looks like the most awesome fun. A dude, he did the descent in his polo helmet 1 year. Yeah, right there. Don't think there's any water going left. I've made that mistake before and ended up in like a dead end where it's just slowly getting less and less. Yeah. There's an island coming up and we usually jag left at the island. There's some logs across the river on the right and an island. I think you can go straight today, but I'm going to go left. Actually, no, I'm not, because it's too low, so continue. Yeah, forget I said anything, disregard. No. You come around the corner, you'll see the big island in the middle, and there's only just enough space to get onto the left. And I think it's in very low water, that's the way. But today it's high enough to go anywhere. Yeehaw! Yeah, right there, hard right. Yeah, of course. looks good, go right. Yeah, cool. There is a point up here somewhere where right is definitely the way. Now, oh crap, I think this is it. We're fine, just get right as soon as possible. There's one chute left, one channel left. I always come here, and I don't think it's the right way. That big dead tree there, you gotta go somewhere here, and it's pretty, oh, that's all right, yep. Indeed. Where there's water, there's a way. Nice. Missed you by about a millimeter. Alright. This must be the pool above Leatherheads. I know it's similar to Terminator in that the rapids around a right-hand corner from the pool. So you're sort of like this, you see it coming and it's right in front of us now. There it is, excellent. Now watch everybody go left and become a cropper. I mean, I'm sure it's okay, but look at the rocks. I mean, would you do that if you had a choice? Yeah, right side you won't hit a single rock. But it's a, you know, completely different rapid because it's got an island in the middle. So all of these people either never gone right. Have you been right? It's far, far right. I can lead you if you like, but yeah, you're more than welcome, man, because you're doing freaking well. All right, yeah, just come down. It's a piece of piss, eh? You'll just bump down. It's not even as big as Glen Avon. See, like, if you had a choice, why would you do that? It's just not smart. Yeah. What are you doing? Oh yeah. Well, that's the island there, yeah. It's just like, yeah, straight into the chute, eh? And here you go. That's it. Yeah, oh, nice one from Terry. Yeah, get competitive, not for us. Now, is your support crew here? Nice.
Hey, Jack Boy!
Well done, man. I'll see you tomorrow, eh? Woo. Hey, did you want the water bottle? Sorry. Not mine. We found it.